Hi everyone, welcome to the Cookie Couture, where flavor and design collide. Today is the day number 7 of the 12 days of Christmas cookies, and if you are looking to add a recipe to your Christmas cookies repertoire, this is the one for you. And I'm super excited to share this recipe with you, but first, if you're new here in my channel, don't forget to subscribe and push the notification button, and let's get started! Please check in the description of this video for the list of the materials that I used to make these cookies. Let me show you the ingredients. Sugar, almond paste, cage-free eggs, olive oil, sea salt, butter, and flour. And also I am going to be using ribbon pink food gel color and apricot jam. And I am going to start by preheating my oven at 350 Fahrenheit degrees. I am going to start by sifting my flour and set it aside. I am going to use a stand mixer and I am going to use the paddle attachment. Here I have my butter that is at room temperature and I am going to start by creaming it at medium speed for about 1 minute. Now I am going to start adding the sugar gradually, and I will continue mixing until the sugar is incorporated into the butter. Now that the butter looks very nice and smooth, I am going to add the olive oil. Now I am going to add the almond paste and I will continue mixing at the same speed for about 4 to 5 minutes until everything is very nice and fluffy. In the description of this video, I will leave you the link for the recipe. And in the meantime, I'm going to crack 3 eggs and I'm going to beat them slightly. And also, I am going to prepare my baking trays. I am going to use a 13 by 9 inches baking tray and a 9 by 5 loaf pan. I will line them with parchment paper and I will put a little bit of butter and flour. As you can see, the batter is looking very nice, it's light in color and very fluffy. I am going to add the eggs in 3 additions and in between them I'm going to scrape the sides of the bowl so the mixture is very well combined. And if you think that your mix does not look like cookie dough, it's okay, it has to look more like a cake batter. Now, at the lowest speed, I am going to start adding the flour. We are almost done with this part. I am going to stop the mixer and scrape the sides of the bowl once again. And I will be continue mixing for 1 minute at medium speed. Now I am going to divide this batter in 3 equal parts. For this you are going to need a balance and 3 bowls. And I am going to weigh 250 grams in each bowl. Now I am going to tint the batter in 3 different shades of pink. And if you want to make this more festive, you can tint one batter in green, one in red, and one in pink, or you can use different shades of green as well. And if you want, you can add natural or organic food gel color. and be gentle with your butter while you mix this. Remember that I speeded up the video, so this is why it looks so fast. Your butter will be ready when the color is very nice and uniform. Don't overmix the butter. This is my medium shade color. Now I am going to tint the lighter one. And remember that a little bit of fuchsia color goes a long way, so always be careful. And if you want, you can also use your mixer while you tint the butter. But just do this at medium speed for about 1 minute. I'm going to pour the butter into my baking sheets and I am going to bake them. And in this baking tray, I'm going to put two different colors. And just try to level the cake batter so they bake evenly. And I will bake them from 12 to 15 minutes until the center springs back to you after you carefully touch it. And you can also test your cake using a toothpick. And I think so that these cake cookies are ready. As you can see, these are baked. They are bouncy in the center and they smell amazing. Now I'm going to take them out of the baking tray. And remember that your baking tray is very hot, so always use gloves and be very careful. Now I am going to cut this part, and also I am going to cut some edges, and I am going to transfer them to a cooling rack and let them cool down completely. So later on, I can add the apricot jam. Here I have my cake or cookie pieces, and I am going to be sure that they have the same dimensions. So let's check. It fits very nice. Let me check with the other one. I think so that they fit very nice. Now I am going to sandwich together these three pieces, and I am going to put the darkest color in the bottom, then the medium one, and on top the lighter one, and in between each of them I am going to spread apricot jam. Very good, our sandwich is ready. Now I am going to press slightly, and then I am going to cover them with a plastic paper, and I am going to put it in the refrigerator for about 1 hour, and later on we're going to cut out our cake cookies. Now, the only thing that I need to do is to unwrap it, measure it, and cut same size pieces. And using a sharp knife, I am going to cut all the edges, but don't discard these pieces because they are so yummy. I really, really love how these cookies look. Now that I have an even piece, I am going to measure it. I want to cut exactly in the half of this piece. And you can always decide how thick you want your cookies. And I am going to cut some like 3/4 of an inch and some like about 1/2 an inch. Ta-da! Wow, they look amazing. They are not only pretty, but they are super delicious. These cookies deserve a very nice presentation, and I am pretty sure that they're going to look amazing on your dessert table or your cookie platters. Okay guys, this is it for today. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here in my channel, don't forget to subscribe, push the notification button, stay tuned for tomorrow's recipe, and thank you all so much for watching, and see you next time. Bye bye.